in a doctor's surgery, a general practice, a lot of patients have smoking-related diseases and chronic illnesses that are pretty much completely related to smoking, like COPD, which is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, and people with emphysema. Obviously, there are people who've got, you know, things as bad as cancer, not just lung cancer, but all sorts of cancers from smoking.
Well, I wake up in the morning.
I don't really know. Pathological need. It's easy to break the addiction on a short-term basis, but on a long-term basis, it's much more difficult.
Tell me, what have I done wrong? And nothing go right with me, must be I've been smoking.
I find it quite depressing, actually, when I see people smoke, because when you think about what it does to people, it is just really, really sad, because it's basically just poison, and people, you know, are a slave to it, and I just think that's really depressing.
Did it for 6 months. Although, I suppose it's not quite the same, I didn't cold turkey. I smoked while I drank, and I smoked an occasional cigar. So I suppose nicotine levels were being topped up. But if you have anything approaching what you would call an addictive personality, then it's extremely difficult. And nothing go right with me, must be I've been
smoking too long. Well, in school, people tend to smoke a lot just to fit in with other people, and, you know, some people don't, you know, smoke all the time, but say we're all out drinking, one of my friends who doesn't smoke a fag, and she just starts smoking, and that's her stuff.
Well, in this blues I'm singing, there's a lesson to be learned. Don't go around smoking unless you want to.
Tell me, what have I done wrong? It's a tough question, that, because obviously you've got free will. If someone wants to smoke, they should be able to, really.
I think it's pretty much, it's not impossible, but I think it would be incredibly difficult for them to make it illegal, but I do think they could make it more difficult for people to smoke by maybe increasing tax even more.
Well, I wake up in the morning, look at my clock. It's way past noontime, no, I'm late for work.
Greatly. You're looking at, say, a pack of 10 a day, on average. Even if it's only 5 days a week, that's £15 a week. Over the course of a month, you know, you can easily look at £70-80. Especially if you throw in, let's say, a few cigars as well, so it's... It's never prohibitively expensive, though, you know this. A smoker will always pay for their cigarettes.
Well, I wake up in the morning, look at my clock. It's way past noontime, no, I'm late for work. Tell me.
I don't know if the government are right to highly tax it. One of the excuses was, one of the things they said was because it's to cover NHS costs.
I think that the increase is more to sort of prevent people from smoking as much, perhaps, rather than, you know, I don't necessarily want to see the government benefiting us. Yeah. you know, from it. I'd rather just see people, I'm finding it more difficult to afford to buy cigarettes because, you know, the taxes have been increased and all the price of cigarettes has gone up and they can't afford it as easily, and maybe it might force some people to have to stop smoking.
Well, I wake up in the morning, look at my clock. It's way past noontime, though I'm late for work. Tell me, what have I done wrong? And nothing go right with me, must be I've been smoking too long.